of my creativity and visual thinking class, we study the idea of the right brain and the left brain, and have discovered that labyrinths have a way of freeing the right brain, because the left brain has the kind of logical progression of walking around the circle to think about, and the right brain is free to get good ideas. So at the end of every semester, we make a labyrinth, and we made one out of snow and one out of chalk art. And this semester, we decided to make it out of people, which meant that we had to convince about 70 people to come and lay down on the ground in the form of a labyrinth so that we could walk through and free our right brain. And we had a lot of good sports that came out, probably about 50 people. First, we formed some circles that were independent of each other. Everybody got a colored piece of paper to tell them which circle to be in. Then we joined those circles up in a more of a spiral shape, and had to rearrange a few people to get them. So we didn't quite have 70, I think we probably had about 50. And then everybody got a chance to walk through it, and when they were done walking through it, they switched out with somebody who was laying down. Exploring the possibility of a world record. I don't know how big the biggest labyrinth created by people is, but I don't know that it's been set, so it might be a low-hanging fruit that we can set next semester or something. And it's just fun to get people out doing something different and interacting.